Okay, hi everyone. It is 3 o'clock, so that means it's time for Flirty Friday. I'm Susanna Matthews, the date maven, and if you have tuned into the Facebook Live show before, you know that every Friday at 3, we bring you your daily coffee break or Coca-Cola break or whatever you do in your mid-afternoon break with some flirting tips, dating tips, relationship tips, personal image tips, and all related things. And today we're actually doing the show from the Keller Williams offices in the waterfront, and I am joined by my friend Rhonda Welsh, who is an amazing realtor here in Wichita. And there's a very specific reason that I asked her if we could shoot today, and we'll tell you what that is in a little bit. But first of all, thank you, Rhonda.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm really excited because I know Rhonda has some opinions that are really going to be relevant on the things that we're talking about today. And I'm hoping that you will be sure to send in your questions. We're going to have a little bit of ambient sound, but that's okay. We just roll with it. And I'm hoping that you will give us a thumbs up on what you like and a big heart on what you love. And don't hesitate to reach out and kind of chime in on the discussion because we want this to be really organic and involve everybody. So I'm hoping, Rhonda, that you can start off. I've known you for, 6 or 7 years now.
Yes.
And you really just like took this real estate career and went boom. And so when and how did you discover that you had a passion for real estate?
It was by mistake that I got into real estate. It was just, oh yes, I'll do this. A best friend asked me to join. And then once I realized I was actually helping people during some of the most critical times of their life, whether it's divorce, loss of a significant other, getting married, first-time home buyers, there's just a lot of different really major events in their life that I realized this is my passion of helping people through those things anyway, and then helping them find a home or sell a home, and it just all fit in with helping people.
Yeah, and I know you to be such a relationship-oriented person, and so it was no like stretch at all for me to, oh yeah, that makes total sense for her to be a real estate professional. So one of the things that I was hoping we could tap into is some of your expertise around those life changes. So when a relationship ends, that sometimes prompts a real estate change. When a relationship goes to the next level, maybe you've been dating a while, it's time to cohabitate, or you're getting married, that also motivates a real estate purchase.
Yes.
So what kinds of tips or pieces of advice do you have for people who might be in one of those two camps?
The very first thing they need to do is meet with a realtor and have them walk them through the process of what are the steps. If we have two homes, but now we're combining our life and we want to sell one, we want to sell both and buy a new one, what are the steps we need to do? If they're first-time home buyers, you know, they need to get with a realtor who can get them with the right lender. There's just so many steps to it that they need to start with a realtor.
Okay, right. So that the purpose there is guidance and connection to other resources and other experts as well. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So if you are in that situation of maybe it's time to exit a relationship that hasn't been working so well, or really show your commitment to the person you're with by buying a home together, then Rhonda is the person to see. And we will let you know at the end of the show how to get a hold of Rhonda. I've actually asked her not to run off and go anywhere because I want to talk about some tips for men in particular this week. Oftentimes, I find myself... women seem to be the ones kind of like feeding the beast, so to speak, and sending me questions and sending me prompts. And so I wanted to make sure I wasn't neglecting the men at all. So I have a few points for men, how you can elevate your dating and relationship game. And I thought we would start with the topic of grooming. Last night, this came up with a very good friend of mine, the subject of goatees. And she was anti-goatee, and I was pro goatee. And it seems like that can be a little bit of a deal breaker for some women. And so if you're watching and you're female, you have an opinion, I want to hear what you think about goatees. I know beards are really big right now. And my only thought about that is keep it trimmed, keep it oiled, make sure that it becomes part of your self-care, gentlemen. Because I do see some left swiping going on with four ladies with the men whose beards are going to be a little unmanageable and out of control and unkempt looking. What do you think, Rhonda?
I have a very personal opinion about it, and I like really clean shaven, short hair, but that's plenty of other women out there that like it the other way, but I do agree with the grooming and taking care of it if you are grooming.
Yeah. Make sure it smells nice if you want her to get clothes. Make sure that you're going to a barber, not just asking your cousins, friends, neighbors, sisters, beauty school dropout, niece, whatever. You get my point. But make sure you're actually investing in that part of your self-care. And same with the hair. I know a lot of guys who are losing their hair, they just go ahead and shave it. A lot of guys are hanging on for all their work. Whatever you decide to do, get the opinion and the support of a professional who's actually dealt with that grooming challenge before. And if you are a busy guy, I know a lot of people try to like cut corners in the morning as they're getting ready. You can spend 3 minutes on your self-care and your image for the day. It will pay off. Women notice. That's all I'm saying. Women notice.
Yes.
All right. So the next topic for the men I was thinking about was fashion. And I know a lot of the men that I've worked with as a dating coach have needed a little bit of guidance and support in the style department. So sometimes we go shopping. Sometimes we do closet edits. Sometimes we say, I'm not going to make you burn this, but I'm never letting you wear this on a date. This is never leaving the house or your yard. This is your mowing section of your closet. And this is the going out in public section. So that can be really useful. I know I have a couple of personal pet peeves when it comes to clothes. And one is, men, I'm sorry. I know you love your cargo shorts, but... Okay, here's the thing. Here's what men don't realize. I get they're comfy, you have a place for your keys and your cell phone and all that. I get it, it's utilitarian. But unless you are an exceptionally tall man, like the tall of the tall, those cargo shorts are cutting you off. They're making you look heavier than you really are and dumpier than you really are. And you just kind of have that dad bod look, even if you don't really have a dad bod, which you might, that's fine. But the cargo shorts are definitely something to put in that lawn mowing section of the closet that I was talking about, not the going out on a first date section of the closet. And I was like really nervous that the gentleman who was just walking through off camera might have been wearing cargo shorts as I was talking about it. And he was going to be like, what's up? Why are you lecturing me about cargo shorts? I don't even know you. All right, so we dodged that bullet. But what about you? Is there anything that you've seen men wear that you thought, yeah, that's a really bold choice, I like that, bravo for your fashion, or anything that's rubbed you the wrong way, wrong desk?
One thing that came to mind when we were speaking, Susanna, was one guy had a pink, really nice dress shirt, and it was wonderful. He looked great in it, but he wore it every single date.
Oh.
Because it might have been his only date.
That was
nice
his
shirt.
Only date shirt. Someone told him he looked nice in it,
yes.
And he kept coming back. Yeah, so bravo for color to that guy, and not being afraid to wear pink. And you know, guys, go for the patterns. Kind of get out of your rut, get out of your lane. But think about fit. Fit is everything. So a lot of guys, you know, women gain and lose weight, men gain and lose weight. They just kind of keep wearing the same stuff because maybe they don't want to spend the money on themselves, or they don't enjoy shopping, and so they just kind of keep wearing that stuff that's too large. But that you're not doing yourself or your body or your date any favors, because she wants to see what you look like. She wants to see that you're a masculine, well-dressed guy. You're willing to kind of put forth that little bit of extra effort. That lets her know she is special and she's respected, and you took the time to think about her and what she would like. Home is probably my most heavily opinionated, richly opinionated topic for today. So many do's, so many notes. So one of the things I was gonna tell the guys is invite a female friend or a sister or coworker over to your house and ask them for some tough love feedback. How does this present? If you were a single lady coming to my house for drinks, maybe third, fourth, fifth date, getting to know each other better, maybe we're gonna cook out in the backyard, maybe we're gonna sit in a hot tub. There's an impression that's being formed, right? That in her mind, she's like noticing the things. And most of the time, we don't notice the stuff that we're used to in our environment because it's just there all the time. So would you have any tips for men as far as how to make their home a little bit more female friendly?
I do agree with having another female come in, and if it is because someone that's too close that won't be brutally honest, I even have a stager for a very minimal fee that would come in, because that's what I use her for, is I don't want to be the bad guy and tell them, you know, what their house looks like and what's bad and take it down and don't do this. But this stager, that's her job and she's an expert at it, and she would love to come in and tell a man how to make it where it's not girly, but it will welcome a woman.
Yeah.
So that would be one thing. But the smells, I think we talked about that.
Talked about that beforehand. So here's the thing, when you live there, you don't know what your house smells like because you are immersed in that environment day after day after day. But I'm sure you've walked into many homes where you thought, oh, this home isn't going to sell or it's going to be a challenge because of an odor.
Yes.
So what do you advise them to do?
Definitely no smoking in the house. If there's pets, whatever you can do to get the odor of pets out is one thing. And just senseis or candles or anything like that on a regular basis. Even cleaning the carpet will sometimes take that out.
Yeah. So she's concerned about selling your house. I'm concerned about helping you make romance in your house. And it's just kind of it's not conducive to intimacy. It's not conducive to sexuality if your house smells bad. So again, there are like air ionizers and neutralizers that you can use. There are really nice room sprays. I would actually maybe invest in something a little bit better, not just the Glade spray, because sometimes those, they don't last very long and they mask the scent in kind of a icky, super sweet way. It's not gonna smell like a man's place. Maybe lighting some, you know, they do candles now that are really masculine. They have like the oak and the tobacco and the leather and all those masculine scents. So I would do that. Guys, I also wanna tell you, put up a few framed pictures of yourself and your family around the house. If you have nieces or nephews, or if you have grown kids or little kids, put up some framed pictures of the people you love. That sends an emotional message to the lady and a subconscious signal that you have good, healthy relationship bonds. There are people who love you that you love back. And those are all good, like, sort of green flag signals in her brain. I also would suggest you might, if you can keep it alive, keep a plant. That kind of gives it a warmth and a welcoming vibe. Guys, this is really, 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 really important. If you take nothing else away from this Facebook Flirty Friday today, take this away. Have a clean hand towel in your bathroom. Have you ever been using a gentleman's bathroom, just washing your hands after you've gone to the restroom, and there's nothing there but maybe a beach towel or his bath towel, and that feels a little intimate and invasive to be wiping your hands on that, right? You're like, what am I supposed to do? Do I air dry? So at least one, maybe more than one.
Yes, not the one that you just changed the oil in your car and then washed your hands.
Not that one,
yes.
Right. Yeah, a fresh, clean hand towel. And then I would also add for when things kind of progress to, you know, a certain moment in the relationship, you want to have some wet wipes in the restroom as well. And if you don't know why I'm suggesting that, you can message me off camera. So, all right. That's enough about the house. Shall we talk about cooking?
Yes.
Do you cook?
I do.
You are a cook?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Do you have a couple specialties that you would make if you were having a gentleman over?
I do some meatballs that are really, really good, and I do hummus.
Oh, yum.
Yes, yes.
Hummus is heart-winning for me.
Yes,
yeah.
Me too.
I love hummus, and it's kind of healthy-ish, so
yes.
All right, so guys, I know that probably there's not a lot of time to cook, there's not a lot of time to plan and grocery shop, and maybe you just really never learned. I mean, some guys are cooks and some aren't, and that's fine. But you can make a super simple appetizer so that if you're having a lady over to Netflix and chill or whatever you're gonna do, take a walk, whatever. So I would suggest hummus with pita wedges and some little veggie strips would be beyond simple.
Yes.
Okay, it'll take you like 10 minutes or less. Someone I know introduced me and turned me on to burrata this week, which is a delicious cheese. So it's like ricotta on the inside and mozzarella on the outside, and it's drizzled with balsamic reduction or balsamic vinaigrette, some little roasted tomatoes, or if you don't want to roast them, you can just slice some fresh tomatoes from the garden, little toast points. Don't freak out, man, that I just said toast points and you're like, I don't know what a point is. If you can slice a baguette of French bread or a ciabatta bread from the grocery store, you can toast those suckers and maybe put a little garlic butter on them. Anyway, again, I want to hit it home that it is easy, easy, easy.
Yes.
You should, you know, fix up your house, get yourself ready, and then start your food. All this can probably be done within an hour or a couple. hours before she comes over and you're not greeting her at the door in your cargo shorts. Okay? Okay. I'm being really uppity about the cargo shorts. I know. I'm sorry. Okay. Anything else we should add? What should we throw in there?
I don't know.
Kind of put you on the spot. Yes. But yeah, I think, you know, don't be afraid to entertain at home. It's probably not date one, maybe not even date two.
Right.
But sometimes people get worried about, I don't know, being seen out and about because maybe they're very private or they just get worried about the expense of going out. And you can really have, in many ways, a more quality conversation with your date at home because you're not trying to kind of beat the roar of the crowd in a restaurant. Lots of restaurants are really noisy. You know, you can have a little more physical contact. If you're an affectionate person, you want to do a little flirting and arm touching, there's a little more opportunity for that to go on at home than I think there is when you're seated across the table from someone at a restaurant. So don't be shy about entertaining at home. Gentlemen, I hope that you have found these tips helpful. Producer Chrissy, did we have any questions come across that we need to answer?
Well, Lisa Marie says hello. Oh, and so does Shiana.
Aw, hey girls.
And Jason Jin said, men don't need to look older than they already do. This is when you were talking about hair.
Yeah, I'm going to agree with you, Jason. So maybe we should have him on to give some tips from a guy for the guys. All right, thanks for watching, everyone. So I want to wish everyone a great weekend. Rhonda, if they have questions about where and what to buy and what to do to get ready to sell, how can they get a hold of you?
Wonderful. They can call me at 316-409-4431, or you can email me at rhonda@rhondawelsh.com, and it's rhondawelsh.
So she's going to set you up with your dream home. I'm going to set you up with your dream partner. The best way to get a hold of me is Suzanna@thedatemaven.com. That's Suzanna@thedatemaven.com. We hope that you will enjoy these Flirty Friday Facebook Live shows enough to share them with your friends. And we will be reposting this on the Date Maven page again tomorrow. And I think it will be on your Facebook as well.
Yes, yes.
So if you're friends with one of us, then you will have a way to access this video. And if you do have any questions or topics that you want to have addressed in a future show, just email those to me or send them via Facebook message. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next week. Mwah! Bye.